What you're looking at is a truly remarkable specimen. It looks a lot like the famous Starchild Skull of Lloyd Pye, which was found in Mexico, I believe in the 1930s or 1950s. But this is not Mexico. This is Peru. What's really interesting about it is you notice the eye sockets. You see how shallow they are. Also, obviously, you see in comparison to the size of my hand how tiny the skull is. And as well, it would appear to me, but I'm not a doctor, that something is very different about the sinus structure. It doesn't seem to have the same sinus system that a normal human has. What it does have is the normal number of cranial plates that a human being has, but then also this very strange cut that is in the forehead there. And so the question to ask and to be answered by medical professionals is, are we looking at a diseased child that died in the distant past, that had some kind of strange disease abnormality? Or are we in fact looking at something very similar to what the star child is, that according to DNA testing isn't human as you and I would define Homo sapiens sapiens? It's just one of many intriguing anomalies that one finds in a country like Peru that has such an incredible history of human culture. And if nothing else, an incredibly intriguing artifact.